there's never been any therapy. The only therapy we have so far is cochlear implant for profound severe hearing loss children. So this is the very first time that a biological or drug-like approach can be used to treat the children with congenital deafness. Children are born completely deaf, but after the treatment, they get a hearing back, they get a speech back. They can hear almost as well as we do, and they can speak. So this is a profoundly important step. It's really the historical moment in the development of new treatment for hearing.
With parents, realize that they have response to sound, and they feel really, really excited, and they cried, and the whole family cried. After assessment from the hearing test, so I told them, it's sure, and it works, and they cried again. And my students, also my team, they also cried. It's really exciting moment.
It's just wonderful, one of the most thrilling moment in life. So this is really the first time where a revolutionary new treatment become reality, where the treatment can bring the natural hearing back to the children and for the rest of their lives. They can hear all the nuances of the sound, different, you know, bird chirping, the music, or all sort of sound where we consider normal, we don't even pay attention to. Now they can suddenly experience them for themselves for the first time.
We would like to try other deafness genes because there are so many deafness genes and there are so many deafness patients. We want to translate to other genes and to help more patients.
Gene therapy is really to show the proof of concept is a gateway for us to develop treatment for other type of hearing loss, such as age-related hearing loss, a noise-induced hearing loss, which affects millions of people. So our ultimate goal is really to be able to develop treatment for as many patients as possible.